Hello mga kamit mi, Kuya mo Felix, mga kaibigan, nagbabalik na naman para sa isa nating calculator technique. And this calculator technique is under engineering economics. And that topic is ordinary annuity. So konting lecture lang tayo sa ordinary annuity, di ba? So ordinary annuity is equal amount of payments na binabayaran natin every end ng certain period or certain years, commonly used. And ito yung gagamitin natin calculator technique, no? Summation na formula. And please take note guys, no, this is just the present worth nung annuity kapag tatakbo siya for some certain years. So definitely, usually yung kapartner ng mga questions nito is may kasamang compounding or future worth. So dapat take note nyo din yung formula ng future worth, no. Yung future worth ng compounding is present 1 plus rate divided by n, or yung compounding, times number of years times n. So usually naman kapag yearly, or usually naman yearly si annuity talaga, masisimplify natin yan, lalo na kung effective rate yung gamit, is I raised to number of years. So ganyan lang naman ginagamit natin kapag yearly or annually. So without further ado, let's have some examples. Okay, let's try this problem. What is the accumulated amount of a 5-year annuity paying 6,000 pesos at the end of each year? Definitely, this is ordinary kasi at the end of each year with interest at 15% compounded annually. So may compounding din siyang naganap. Pero first, let's get the present worth muna nung ating annuity, which is, that is annuity, based dun sa formula natin, summation na 1 over 1 plus interest raised to x, where x is equal to 1, tapos yung number of years na mag-iipon ka. So, ang present worth natin dyan is magiging 6,000 summation from 1 over, since 15% yan, gawin ko na lang 0.15 para mabilis, raise to x, no? And x is equal to 1 to 5. Okay? So, makuha natin yung present worth. Calculator. So, that is 6,000, no? 6,000 shift summation, no, yung summation symbol, 1 over 1.15 kasi yun lang naman yung binigay na interest, or yes, interest rate, no, with interest, tapos from 1 to 5 tayo. Please take note guys, no, ito yung crucial dito sa ordinary annuity, ito yung gagamitin mong formula, 1 to n, kasi at every end of year eh. So pag inequal mo yan guys, this is just the present worth ng total annuity natin, which is 112.93. So para safe, i-shift store ako yan. So in-store ko sa A, and definitely para makuha natin yung future worth is kukumpitin natin yung compounding niya, which is 1 plus I raised to number of years, and that is, di ba in-store ko sa A, so i-store na lang, and that is 1.15, di ba, kasi 15% raised to 5. So therefore, our future worth will become alpha A times 1.15 raised to 5, kasi 5 years na kocompound annually. So therefore, the answer is 4.29. Correct. So ito yung sabot natin, 4.29. So that is your final answer. Correct answer is letter Z. Correct. Okay. Let's have another example. Eto. Find the annual payment to extinguish a debt of 10,000 pesos payable for 6 years at 12% interest annually. So walang compounding naman na binanggit. So definitely this is pure annuity problem. Kung babalikan natin yung formula natin, annuity is equal to summation ng 1 over 1 plus I raised to x, from x is equal to 1 going to n, up to n. Now, ang problem dito is, ang kulang is, ang nawawala ay annual payment. So yung annuity yung nawawala, pero may debt ka daw na 10,000. So yun yung magiging present worth mo, yan 10,000 na yan. Okay? Is equal to A, summation ng 1 over 12 years, no? So that is 1.12 raised to x, x is equal to 1 up to 6 years. So since A yung hinahanap natin dyan, edi A over A lang natin, A over natin, no? So A is equal to 10,000, 1, 2, 3, divided by no? Summation ng x is equal to 1 to 6. Tapos yan, lalagay mo lang yan, 1.12 raised to x. So makukuha natin yung annuity niyan. So therefore, lagay lang natin sa calculator natin yan, that is 10123 divided by shift summation, kasi summation yung kailangan natin, that is 1 over 1.12 raised to x. Naka-raise to x ba? Hindi naka-raise to x. Raise to x. Then, ang x natin is from 1 to 2 to 6. Tama, no? Kasi annual payment to extinguish payable for 6 years. So, pag wala naman sinabi restrictions, definitely ordinary annuity lang yan. So, therefore, the answer is 2432.26. Correct. So, lahat ang sagot natin dyan is 2432.26. Beautiful math. So the answer is letter C. Ayan. So try nyo to sa other problems nyo na meron kayo ngayon para ma-practice ninyo. And definitely, kung may natutunan ka dito, share mo na din sa friends mo para share-share lang tayo ng knowledge dito. Kasi kayo mo, Felix, nagsasabi na do not study until you get it right. Study until you cannot get it wrong. Study hard, study smart. See you in my next video, guys. Bye!